Hello guys, Mydale here. Today's video will be a journey back in time where we look at some very early character and creature models from the first years of the development of World of Warcraft before the release in 2004. Most of the models don't appear in the game, but they are still very detailed and there are many animations associated with them. Clearly, they appear to have been intended to go in the game, but they were scrapped. Let's get started right away and look at our first model. The model you see on the screen was the first interesting model I stumbled upon, and I was quick to find it. The model has the second lowest display ID in the game, and it's of a human female. Seeing a side-by-side comparison with the player model, they don't look the same at all. The facial features are not at all similar, and the animations are different as well. An example is the unarmed attack animation that's very exaggerated for the weird model. She's swinging her whole body while attacking. It looks like she could be in the UFC, while the player model's animation is more tempered. The death animations are different as well. The weird model sort of falls together like a sack of potatoes, while the player model has some more movement. There are many different skins of the model, like this one, and this, to show just two more examples. But yet, the model is not used anywhere in any version of WoW as far as I know. And there are more examples of the same kind. Here, you see another human female model that's also different from the player model. They look more alike and some of the animations look the same or very close to the same as well, but the faces in particular are different and also the portrait pictures. There are different skins for the model, although it can be hard to decide which skins are the same model. Here you see another example, but then there's this one that looks very similar, I would say, but if you check some of the animations, they're not the same. The most interesting human female model, in my opinion, however, is the wizard. The wizard has a unique jumping animation which few of the models we'll be looking at today have. The jump looks pretty funny, but the existence of the animation actually tells a lot. It could indicate that the model was intended for players at some point. There are also unique casting animations that I have never seen in-game. Here's me casting a fireball. Here's Flamestrike, where the animation looks very unusual. And here's Arcane Explosion. Here's another skin and all the animations side by side with the player model's animations. I was pretty amazed to discover a model and animations like this, and we've got more coming. My assumption would be that we are looking at a very early version of the human female player model, or maybe a sort of test model. In any case, it's very cool in my opinion. Here, we see a special troll model that you will likely recognize from Strangleform Vale, where it's used a few places. There are some pretty awesome skins, however, that are not used. Like this one, where the troll is carrying some wooden sticks with bloody skulls on his back. There's also this version with a mask. And then there are ice trolls like this that has the name Frostmane in its file name. The Frostmane trolls are found in Dunmoreau, where they use the regular troll player models. But it's very possible that that wasn't always going to be the case. There's also this skin that has a wolf's head helm, which looks pretty crazy and would have been awesome in the game. By the way, the models have sort of the same stance as the old troll female model, so I wonder if there are some connections there. Let's look at some of the many weird human male models that are also found in the game files, like the one seen here. It looks very different to the player model. The body is very blocky and the legs are about twice as thick as the human character models. The feet appear to be double the size as well, while the heads are scaled similarly. There are other skins like the chubby wizard, and this fancy gentleman with his stylish clothing. The model looks pretty funny seen from the back while the running animation is going. As I said, there are many different human male models. I like this one in particular because it's actually used in-game in a few places that I know of, by Colonel Kurtzen in Strangleform Vale in the case of this exact skin. It's quite similar to the player model, but one point where it stands out is with the attack animations. If you have fought Kurtzen in Strangleform, you will probably have noticed the difference. The model is also used by many of the pirates in Stranglethorn and Captain Heckleberry Smuts in Booty Bay, for example. They are just different skins. I found a Scarlet Crusade model as well that shares a lot of features with the Scarlet Champion from the Scarlet Monastery. And then there are the wizard skins that look very distinct. There's this one, but also a much crazier looking one like this. He's got tattoos on his face, which I don't think is a feature of even NPC human player models. Check this guy out too. He looks just as sinister and could easily have been a boss encounter or something like that. Common for all the wizard skins is that they are dressed in robes that aren't obtainable in the game. They all have this white color at the top and they look pretty cool actually. The spell animations are special too. Here you see me throwing a few fireballs. Here's Flamestrike and Arcane Explosion. They don't look bad, but a bit funny and exaggerated. Here's the female version, by the way. But the most unusual human model yet is the one seen here. Not because of the skin, but because of the animations. It has a lot of the player emotes. There's a unique dance seen here that's totally different from the player model dance. Here's the sitting animation. And here's the jumping animation. A lot of the other emotes look very similar to the player models with some minor differences. The casting animations look similar to those we looked at with the wizard skins before, but they're slightly bugged and there are some differences. The arcane explosion animations are pretty far apart, but also the animations when the fireballs are thrown. Another thing to note is the portrait picture used by the model. It faces to the right like every player model portrait as opposed to monster portraits from non-player models that face to the left. That could very well be an indication that this particular model at some point during the early testing of WoW was the human player model with the animations we've just seen. The attack animations are the same as those used by Kurtzen and the other skins, by the way. And now for a gnome model that shocked me a bit when I first saw it. Both because of the slightly scary appearance, but also because I didn't expect to see a unique gnome model. It looks very different to the player model. It's slightly shorter, slightly wider, and then the face looks a lot less friendly with the nose being much bigger. The face looks more like a gremlin's and the whole model like it could be a worker for an evil Santa Claus or something like that. Like an evil elf. The hair on the arms looks pretty weird too. There are no spell channeling animations, but there are animations from when spells are thrown. When I fire Fireball or use Fire Blast, for example, the model does like a hump movement that would have been pretty ridiculous if it had actually been in the game. The Arcane Explosion animation looks very weird as well and very theatrical, like the kind of exaggerated movement you would make if you just finished an act and are thanking the audience. Beware, because there's also a Leper Gnome version that looks hideous. The clothing is the same as the first skin it would appear, the colors are just different like the skin and hair color. I thought it was pretty interesting that there are both a regular version and a leper version. I wonder if this was possibly one of the first gnome models that were ever made. Now for an undead model that I stumbled upon. We're looking at it here on the screen and you can see the posture looks pretty identical to the player models, even the little movements the models do when they're standing still. The faces, however, aren't very similar and there are no bones showing on the special model. Let's try to hit the jump key. The jumps are very different. The jump from the special model looks like how I would imagine a zombie jumping if it was about to dive onto a target. I can almost hear the zombie sound playing in the background. I do think it would get tiring to look at if it was the actual undead jump animation because it's so unnatural. Could you imagine jumping around like this, in-game or in real life? I much prefer the animation we ended up getting. The casting animations look mostly similar except the type used when you cast spells like Flamestrike and Arcane Explosion. Here, the model bends slightly forward, throws its arms to the side a bit, and does an angry movement like it could be saying, "You don't tell me what to do." There are a lot of similarities with the player model, and once again it makes me wonder if this was an early version of it. The portrait also faces to the right. My guess would be that this was indeed what undead males were supposed to look like at some point. The last model I want to bring up is of the orc that we see here. It looks like a Blackrock orc because of the color, but other than that it doesn't really stand out. The model is unique, however. The spell throw animation for a spell like Shadow Bolt, for example, is much slower than the player model animation. Let's try to use Life Tap. The difference is even greater. Here, the special model uses an animation where it throws its left hand forward and up and then back behind the body. The player model throws its left hand forward and up as well, but it stays there until the animation is finished. The jumping animations are different too, although it's bugged for the Blackrock Orc. A last thing to note is that the portrait of the Blackrock model faces to the right, which makes it likely that it was supposed to be a player model. Not this particular skin, but the model. Similar to my speculations about the undead model before, maybe this was the first version of the Orc player model before it was refined and polished into the model we know today. That was all I had for the video. I hope you were surprised by some of the models just like I was when I discovered them. I certainly didn't expect to find a unique gnome model, and the human model with the special dancing animation was one of the other big surprises. Some of the models, especially the first ones we looked at, don't really seem like they belong in World of Warcraft. The art style doesn't seem to fit. It's a bit too realistic and lacks a cartoonish touch. They must have been made at a point when WoW was very early in development and the art direction hadn't been settled on. I think it's great that there are old unused models and skins in the game files, so we get the chance to look at them here so many years later. I understand why some of them weren't used, they don't really fit into the universe, but at the same time I also think there were some very cool ones that could have made it. Some of the troll skins are awesome, and you could have used the special gnome model a few times in a dungeon like Gnomeregan perhaps. If I'd continued looking, I might have found even more special models and skins, so who knows what's left out there. There might be whole families more of weird looking gnomes with very hairy arms, but probably not. But that'll be it for now. Thanks for watching the video, guys. If you enjoy this type of video that's more data mining oriented, let me know and I'll try to look into other topics. Take care, everybody.